to be back. I'm let loose from the noose that kept me hanging about. I'm looking at the sky cause it's getting me high. Forget the hearse cause I'll never die. I got 9 lives, cat's eyes, abusing every one of them and running wild. I'm number one with a bullet, I'm a power pack. Yes, I'm in a bang with a gang. You gotta catch me if you wanna hang. Cause I'm back on the track and I'm beating the flat. Nobody's gonna get me on another rap. So look at me now, I'm just making my play. Don't try to push your luck, just get out of my way. Cause I'm
back.
Grammy from Bangkok, Thailand, Earth. I don't know the exact coordinate, but it's like somewhere in the solar system. And you're watching BJ Rubin Show. Back in Black.
What is in the word performance? The next band, Forma.
Thank you.
This is Yoko. You are watching BJ Rubin Show.
Coming up next. This is not this heat.
This is not this heat.
So stick around.
Who are you and why are you famous?
I thought we just said you were.
I don't know who I am. I'm still trying to work that one out. How about you? And fame can go and fuck itself. That's just meaningless.
No, but I mean, you guys are famous for being in a band, I think. Like Charles, you're famous as a drummer. Charles, you're famous as... You guys are famous musicians, right? I've certainly heard of you without having met you.
Okay.
Famous is one way to describe... It's a spectrum. It's not like either you are
okay.
or you aren't. You
well,
know what I mean?
We've worked at our music and people like it. And that's
for,
the...
For a long time, yeah.
That's the sort of...
Okay.
The result of that.
So what inspired you guys originally to start this heat?
It's not quite like that. It's more like a process, and then you end up finding that something's working, and then you keep doing it, and then you sort of work on it more, and it becomes better and better, and that's what it is. It's not really a question of starting with the motivation, other than music, I suppose. It's just the making of the thing.
Yeah, you grow up hearing music, and you want to get involved in making music.
What are your influences, musical or otherwise?
Personally, I'm not into taking other music and using that to make music. I'm into taking things from just being inside the world and then making that into music.
Which was always our attitude anyway, really.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you've got to understand, we're talking about 40 years ago, so in a weird sort of way, we're also talking about now, and it all gets a bit weird.
Yeah. Well, according to John Peel, there are no bands like this.
No. It's more a question of people coming to the music and then deciding they like that music. It's not for us to be like the people that say this is how it works or this is what made it happen. It's for other people to enjoy the music and then they can ask us questions and we can answer them. But that's maybe not a question we want to answer.
Yeah, I don't really know how to answer it now.
All right, how about this one then? Describe reality.
When it's good, it's a constant unfolding, and when it's bad, it's like stasis.
Fucked up. It says on the wall there. Reality's fucked up.
What's your earliest memory?
What's your earliest memory?
Yeah, Daniel, what's your earliest memory?
Eating cat food. Eating my cat Gemma's food and going unnoticed for a very long time and then being very weirded out when my mom freaked out about it. Didn't understand. Been doing it for ages.
I've got one. I remember my first. I was less than 2 years old. I'm sitting in a tin bath on a kitchen table in Hope Street in Liverpool. And my...
Are you going to tell me this story?
Yeah, I am. Apparently, I am. And I'm sitting there happily, and I'm pre-verbal. And then I see my grandmother walk up towards me. And she looks down in the bath water. She goes... She says something, which I don't know, because I don't really know words yet. She goes, and she must be saying, "Oh dear, Charles has done a poo in his bath."
Abject memories, basically.
And I remember looking down and thinking, oh, they're really upset about this, you know.
That's so weird. That's kind of the same thing. Yeah. The cat food thing and the pooing in the tin bath.
Yeah, they are both very similar. Yeah.
So these grown-up people, these big people that are around me, they're really upset at this. Oh, so did that came from inside me? Oh, did it? Oh, right. You know, it's like with the first awareness of like, taboo. You're not supposed to do that.
Taboo.
Yeah, what I'm getting from that is you're saying it's pre-verbal, but you're using words to describe it.
Well, right.
Sometimes I'm thinking to myself, memory is actually platformed inside language, and that you're actually talking about maybe a moment when the verbal switched in.
Yeah, because, well, yeah, the sort of the taboo, like the, I thought you just said taboo, yeah.
What about you, James, got anything? I can remember someone saying to me, pass me that, and it was behind me, and I turned round expecting there to be somebody else to pass the thing, because I thought I was a wall. I thought I was just like a camera. And then suddenly I realised that there was a behind me and there was an around me, and that when someone said you, they were talking to me.
What sort of age?
Well, I'm not sure, maybe...
Very young.
Very, very young, and it jolted me into this sort of like oh,
two,
wow.
Two or three.
Yeah, sort of suddenly becoming aware of being aware, as opposed to just being aware. When music's great for me, I don't know about you guys, but it's like that moment gets reversed.
Yeah, separateness.
That separateness goes away.
This is Not This Heat, and you are watching The BJ Rubin Show. This is Not This Heat, and you are watching The BJ Rubin Show. Coming up next, CD Films. Coming up next, CD Films.
All right, we're good.
Every single time feels like the first time. Happy as always.
I like cats.
It's a wonderful feeling to see small creatures. It's pretty hard to get me mad at someone.
It's hard sometimes, though.
It is.
It's, if someone's given it to you, it's hard not to give it back.
It's good to spread some positive energy, so if you're mean when other people's mean, then you're spreading the meanness. But if you're nice, or try to forgive people, that's a tough lesson in life. Try to forgive. It's the mojo in your aura, BJ.
It's the mojo in my aura. You heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen.
Be nice.
The person I think that I forgive the most often is myself, because I make mistakes all the time and it drives me crazy. And I try to just let go and remember that everybody makes mistakes. I found that happens a lot, that I admit things to people. I show some kind of weakness and their face lights up. They're like, that happens to me all the time. This thing that happened to you always happens to me. Mm-hmm. And so it's a way that we can bond with each other. I feel like the adage is to show no weakness, right? And that's how you really are supposed to get ahead. But I don't find that that's a good way to live your life, and that we as humans are weak and we make mistakes and none of us are perfect. And the more that we could see everyone as being like that, then I think it would probably be a better place. When I think about a joke, I think about it as a mistake. For instance, the classic of someone falling over. I mean, you're not supposed to fall over, so that's a mistake. But that's what's funny is the mistake. Everybody makes mistakes all the time, especially me.
It's good to surprise people sometimes with those, well, mistakes, but people might enjoy them. Don't be too tough on yourself. Just enjoy life. You're watching The BJ Rubin Show.
Look, today has been one of those days where every single thing that could have possibly gone wrong has gone wrong.
It's true.
So anyway, I've been having a lot of anxiety and my normal ways of coping with it haven't been working. And I've been having trouble breathing and I've been having a lot of technical problems. So I've just been kind of depressed. It's been cold outside. I mean, I feel like this is all normal for this time of year. But again, when you're experiencing it, it's not always easy.
True.
You know, I turned 40.
Congratulations.
Yeah, and I feel like it's all been downhill from there. A lot of people would probably love to trade places with me nonetheless. And they look at my life, they're like, oh my god, BJ, you have all your hair, you have all your teeth, you're in decent health, you know, you're able to support yourself and live in New York, you have a lot of friends.
It's all sending on the upside here.
You work at the UN, that's cool. You have your own TV show, that's cool. But again, for me, it's hard to see the upside. All I see is the negative. And I'm interested in library music. Anyway, that's something that I'm interested in. I mean, I'm sure you are too.
Of course, library music.
Yeah, library music.
Shh.
You know, you sound like you're not super familiar with it.
No.
So you don't know what that is. So library
silence.
Well, library music was music that was composed specifically to be used as a soundtrack for television and film. And they put these records out, and then, I mean, they weren't available commercially. They were available for, you know, TV studios and movie studios to use as soundtracks.
Okay.
And so library music is like music that's composed for TV and film.
Like,
and
stock music.
Yes. Do you have anything to complain about?
Everything's just so wonderful.
I wouldn't ghost anybody. I mean, I feel like that's just mean.
Keep it real. Keep it real, people.
And then say you're watching the BJ Rubin Show.
You're watching the BJ Rubin Show.
The end is near, ladies and gentlemen. Stick around for the Rapture, live from the Surf Lodge in Montauk. Check it out.
This next song is entitled, Woo! All right! Yeah! Uh-huh.
Good time is a time when, like, you're happy, you can do whatever you want to, you have good people around, so, and you're chilled. So, yeah, good time. Well, like, I can say that I'm totally chilled.
Where are you from originally?
I'm from Nepal.
Is it nice there?
It's very nice there, yeah. That's where I come from, and it's between India and China, and it's a very beautiful country.
So you'd recommend it to people who haven't been there?
Yeah, for sure. Like, if you're looking for adventurous sports, and if you're looking to climb Mount Everest, or if you're looking even to climb, like, mountains, it's definitely a great place. Well, there are quite a lot of things that makes me feel good, but mostly I would say traveling. Traveling makes me really feel good. So far, I've been to quite a lot of countries and met so many people, different cultures, and different experience. So yeah, learning from people and sharing my experience. Yeah, traveling really keeps me happy. Talking behind the back is something very rude.
To think that nobody is saying negative things about you when you're not around is naive.
If you can, you talk good thing about people when they are not there, you know?
I don't know. I have a lot of negative feelings and emotions though, and sometimes I express them.
Mm-hmm.
And by speaking negatively about other people when they're not around.
Yeah, but what I would suggest is, if you would have anything negative about any people, like, just go to that person and sort it out. And I think that really is what you feel, right?
I think you're absolutely right. I just don't think it's always possible. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of times if you express any kind of negativity to people, then they'll just react with more negativity. It's not going to be a productive discussion. And so sometimes you have to vent. I think it's more venting is what I'm doing, you know, when I have a problem with someone and there's nothing I can do about it. So what do you suggest, Ankit? Well, isn't Nepal where people go to find enlightenment?
Well, you can say that. Yeah, many people, like, because Buddha was born there, right? So many people go there for enlightenment. Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And you guys are watching the BJ Rubin show.
But you don't have to use and. Just say you guys. You could say you guys, but you don't need to say and you guys. Because what, I mean, okay, whatever, Ankit. Yeah. I feel like when I try to direct you, it just backfires. You just want to do whatever you want to do, which I appreciate. So just tell them they're watching the show. Tell them the name of the show they're watching. And then introduce a band called U.S. Girls. The name of the band is U.S. Girls.
You guys are watching the BJ Rubin show, and I introduce you to U.S. Girls. You're watching the BJ Rubin show, and I introduce you to U.S. Girls.
What you're trying to do is get people excited about the fact that U.S. Girls is coming on. So, like, it would help if you were excited.
All right, okay. You guys are watching the BJ Rubin show, and I introduce you to U.S. Girls.
You're gonna get it. face or give it up. You just so much do.
Fuck it, fuck you, fuck me, fuck everything, fuck the whole world, fuck the whole fucking universe. It was fun while it lasted. Even if there is a God, that doesn't mean that they have a plan for you. What would Jesus do? Jesus would text you back. Events we attribute to the universe are usually just coincidence. Everyone is different. I keep experiencing the same things over and over and over and over and over. I keep experiencing the same things over and over and over and over. Being intelligent does not make you omniscient. I see, said the blonde man, not building a wall, but making a brick. You can change the mask you wear on the outside, but not how you feel on the inside. If you're so great, why can't you return an email? I'm alive. Take a deep breath. Be careful when looking for mistakes because you might just find one. It was worth a shot. C'est la vie. Vie de merde. Sometimes I think I'm being punished by being given a good life but not being allowed to enjoy it. The tighter you hold on to something, the more it hurts when it is ripped away from you. In the immortal words of Kevin Ayers, it begins with a blessing, but it ends with a curse. The thing that you want the most is always the thing that you can't have. C'est de pont. You'll like this one. I'm not nobody. I'm BJ Rubin. When an unlikely event occurs, make the most of it. Bad karma is inevitable, so don't be afraid of it. Honor thy weakness as a hidden strength. The secret to life is that no one is ever really happy. Life is wasted on the living. Death is wasted on the dead. I worry too much about my image. You can't feel good all the time. You'll never catch me without a brick anymore, even at sea. The world is in my head. My body is in the world. It's not the loss, it's the losing. Behavior is very strange these days. Do you always wear a t-shirt to bed? Somebody is your friend if you both enjoy hanging out together and you like doing it on a regular basis.
Hi, this is Eva van Manen from Amsterdam and you're watching the BJ Rubin show Back in Black. So, people, now all the way from Korea, you'll see Yi Young Lee on the ocarina. Playing for you. And it's so beautiful. So enjoy it.
Hi, I'm Fitri from Indonesia, and you are receiving good news tomorrow.
Running down the stairs. Running down the stairs. Sticky, pokey hairs. Shooting out my neck. Frightening, frightening fears. Things to leave behind. Things to never see. Dark room on the right. Room I'll never leave. I'm never looking back. Never looking back or leaving here. I'm keeping my eyes closed. Keeping my eyes closed. Don't leave me here. Calling from downstairs. Dinner's almost done. What's she gonna do? What will I become? Quick flashes of things I don't wanna say. Quick senses of skin. Didn't wanna stay. I'm never looking back. Never looking back or leaving here. I'm keeping my eyes closed. Keeping my eyes closed. Don't leave me here. Please don't make me go. Please don't make me do it. Please don't make me go. Please don't make me do it. Please don't make me go. Please don't make me do it. Please don't make me go. Please don't make me do it. I'm never looking back. Never looking back or leaving here. I'm keeping my eyes closed. Keeping my eyes closed. Don't leave me here. I'm never looking back. Never looking back or leaving here. I'm keeping my eyes closed. Keeping my eyes closed. Don't leave me here. Don't leave me here. Don't leave me here. Don't leave me here. Me here. Don't leave me here.
Welcome to City Fun, 45 First Avenue in New York City. We sell all legitimate music and graphic t-shirt merch, officially licensed and sanctioned by the bands, the artists, the record labels, or at the very least, officially licensed vendors. We don't sell any bootlegs or any knockoff bullshit of any kind. Everything is chosen on an aesthetic and apolitical basis, and it allows people that do not know most of the bands in here to be attracted to the groups on an aesthetic and artistic level. So you don't have to worry about whether you're a poser if you don't know the Misfits or whether or not Betty Boop is rock and roll. They both are, and they're both great, and they're both legit. It's like to be famous, everybody. Don't want to be a dick.
Final words, any final thoughts?
Any final thoughts? Last words?
I mean, last words is something you say before you die.
Yeah, that's true.
So, I mean, clearly you're about to die. So yeah. What are your last words?
My last final thoughts. Words. Final thoughts.
Final thoughts.
Closing statements.
It's the end, ladies and gentlemen.
This is the end of the episode.
This is the end of the interview.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I could put that at the end of it, but I interrupted you. So
yeah.
Anyway, whatever.
Why don't you just, it's unusable now.
Why don't you just say what you're going to say?
Yeah. This is the end of the episode. Hope to see you, BJ, on the other side.
Maybe we're already there.
True.
Do you imagine me wearing clothes on the other side or no?
Maybe not those clothes.
Do you imagine, am I still human?
Were you human in your lifetime?
That really is the question. Thanks so much. See you next time. All right, I covered that.
Great.
What happens to us when we die?
Well, I mean, your body is recycled. And, you know, bacteria eat you and other small sort of creatures. I mean, what happens to your consciousness? Maybe it stops. Maybe you become a part of a greater consciousness. This is BJ Rubin, and we're going the way that you want to go. BJ Rubin, the BJ Rubin Show, going the way that you want to go since 2010. BJ Rubin, easy to work with. How's my hair?
How's my hair?
How's my hair? I think that people care too much about their image. People care too much about their image.